Today's topic is immunity. Immunity is the capability of multicellular organisms to resist harmful microorganisms from entering the cells, protect us from different types of infections and diseases. There are two types of immunities, innate immunity and adaptive or acquired immunity. Innate immunity is present since birth, while adaptive immunity is acquired one. Adaptive immunity is further divided into natural immunity or artificial immunity. And artificial immunity, natural immunity can be active or passive type. Similarly, artificial immunity can also be of active type or passive type. We are going to study it in detail in our lecture. Number one is innate immunity. It is the inborn immunity that is present since birth, not dependent upon previous exposure to an antigen. It doesn't need any exposure to an antigen to develop. It is present since birth. And there are four types of innate immunity defense barriers. These are anatomical, which is skin, mucous membrane, nasopharynx, cilia, eyelashes, body hair. Physiologic, temperature, low pH. Inflammation is the first response to infection or irritation stimulated by chemical factors released by injured cells. Phagocytosis by neutrophils, macrophages, mast cells, eosinophils, basophils, natural killer cells, dendritic cells. All these are the anatomical barriers. Anatomical, physiologic, inflammation, phagocytosis, these are the barriers for innate immunity. These barriers protect us from getting different types of infections, or once you get infected, that infection is then removed. Our body is cleared from the pathogens through these barriers. So they are involved in innate immunity. They don't require any exposure to previous antigen. Then we have the adaptive immunity that is developed after exposure to a suitable antigen or transfer of antibodies from a donor. Now the types of acquired or adaptive immunity is the active immunity and passive immunity. Active immunity is that one which develops in response to an infection or vaccination. In active immunity, the antibodies are produced by the body itself against infection, but it can be of natural type or artificial type. Natural active immunity is that one in which the antibodies are developed in response to an infection. Example is measles. In measles, once you get infected with measles, antibodies are produced against the infection. But when the measles is over, there is a lifetime natural active immunity which is developed against it. So that is the example of natural active immunity. Then artificial active immunity is that one in which the antibodies developed in response to a vaccination. Antibodies are produced against the antigen, but the antigen is taken in artificially. Example is vaccination, in which you get the antigens in through vaccination, then the antibodies are produced against it. So it's an example of artificial active immunity. It's not a natural one like measles. Then the passive immunity, in which develops after you receive antibodies from someone or somewhere else, like from outside. It can be natural and artificial. Natural is when the antibodies are received from mother to the child through breast milk. The antibodies are directly transferred from mother to the baby. The baby's body is not synthesizing the antibodies itself, but it is getting through mother, but it naturally, through a natural process. So it's a natural passive immunity. An artificial passive immunity is that one in which the antibodies are received from outside, like through medicines. Example is the immunoglobulins injection. When you get the immunoglobulins inside the body, the immunoglobulins are actually the antibodies. So the antibodies are preformed, introduced in the body. So it's an example of artificial passive immunity. The main difference you should understand between the active and passive immunity is that in active immunity, the antibodies are produced by the human body itself in response to an antigen. That antigen can be natural or artificial. And in passive immunity, the antibodies are not produced by the body, human body itself, but they are preformed antibodies that is introduced in the body. And it can be of natural type, like through breast milk when it is transferred from mother to the baby, that naturally, that is the natural passive immunity through milk. And artificial is when you get it entered in your body through artificial method. And these are artificially preformed antibodies introduced in the body. That's the example of passive immunity. It's a very important topic for exams, and you should know the difference in between these two actually. Hope you understood this topic clearly. Take care and thanks for watching.